nothing on the providence I know. No longer bound to things are fully in stone. When all I had to offer was my worst, you saw my heavy heart and loved me first. Your beauty staring down my brokenness, you chose to throw your heart into a mess. Compassion crashing down upon my death. You were there all this time, like a river running through my failure. You carried me all this time, like the splinters buried in your shoulders. You carry me. If ever now my heart cries hallelujah, if ever now in the wonder of your grace, a thousand times, a thousand years, my soul will say, grace. You saw the crushing weight my flesh deserved. You kneeled and wrote forgiveness in the dirt. And one by one the stones for where they lay, as one by one my accusers walked away. With nothing left to throw, they made cross. And knowing only love could count the cost, you were there all this time, like a river running through my failure. You carried me all this time, like the splinters shoulders. Your love carried all my shame. Jesus, how my soul will praise you. You carried me all this way, like a diamond in the scars upon your crown. You carry me. If ever now my heart cries hallelujah, if ever now in the wonder of your grace, a thousand times, a thousand years, my soul will say hallelujah. Jesus, on this rock, I'll sing your praise. Here is love, vast as the ocean, loving kindness as the flood. When the Prince of Life, our ransom, shed for us his precious blood. Who is love will not remember, who can cease to sing his praise. He can never be forgotten throughout heaven's eternal days. crucifixion. Fountains open deep and wide. Through the flood, gates of God's mercy float a vast and gracious tide. Grace and love like mighty rivers poured incessant from above. In heaven's peace and perfect justice kissed a guilty world in love. is just a memory, and tears are no more. We'll enter it as the wedding bells ring. Your bride will come together and we'll sing. You're beautiful. And turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. In the things of earth will grow strange, lead them in the light of his glory and grace. His words shall not fail you, he promised. Believe him and all will be well. Then go to a world that is dying. His perfect salvation to tell. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And the things of earth will grow strange, lead them in the light of his glory and grace.
you, Drew, for those songs and for really preparing our hearts for this time of worship. It's a time of worship where we get to not only celebrate in music, but it's a time of worship where we get to celebrate as we remember the sacrifice that Jesus made for us on the cross as we observe the Lord's Supper tonight. And so this is a special time. It's a serious time for us. This is a time that is reserved for those of us that have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ and for those of us that have invited him in to take complete control of our lives. And so tonight we are going to do just that. We are going to spend some time worshiping as we observe the Lord's Supper. Hopefully you have some bread or some crackers and some juice of some sort. And if you don't, that is okay. We still want you to participate. And honestly, we're not going to get too hung up on what you have in the way of bread or crackers or what you have to drink. That really doesn't matter. What matters is what these items represent. The bread that represents the body that was broken for you, and the juice that represents the blood that Jesus spilled on your behalf. And so if you have those items, we're going to take those together in just a moment. But before we do, before we go any further this evening, let's pray together. Father, we thank you for what we're about to do. We thank you for what we've already been able to do. And so, Father, we pray that all of this tonight is our worship to you. The music, this time now where we come before you, we come humbly, we come with grateful hearts. And so, Father, we pray that as you watch the hearts of your people, as we're gathered in homes all around, Father, we pray that as you watch the hearts of your people tonight, that it would be pleasing to you. And Father, we pray that in these moments, Father, that we would turn our eyes upon you, because it is so easy, especially right now with everything that's going on, for us to be distracted. Father, for our attention to be pulled away from you, and it can happen so fast. And so, Father, we pray that our eyes would be fixed on Jesus tonight. It's in his name we pray. Amen. Well, in these next few moments, and we won't take long tonight, but in these next few moments, we're going to do one thing. We are going to remember Jesus, and we're going to remember the sacrifice that he made for us on the cross so that we could be free. You know, as you think about that word, remember, that's something that is so hard to do sometimes. I know for me, if you're like me at all, it's so easy to forget the things that we need to remember. And for a lot of us, and I would imagine many of us, maybe even most of us, can recall times in our lives where we actually remember the things that we need to forget. And so there's that whole dynamic that's at play as well. And so as we work through that, to try to remember the things that we need to remember, to try to forget the things that we need to forget, that can become so difficult sometimes. I was in Luke chapter 22 this morning, and as I was working through that time, we find Jesus in Luke 22 with his friends in the upper room in Jerusalem celebrating the Passover meal. And so tonight we are going to journey back to that upper room, and we are going to remember Jesus. And we're going to sit down at the table with him, and we're going to listen as he tells us to remember him, because he doesn't want us to forget. In our lives, so many times we can remember the things that we need to forget. In our lives, we can go back and we can think about all those things in our life, all of the sin, all of the junk, all of the mess that was there. And we can become fixated on that. And those are the things that we remember sometimes. But Jesus is asking us to remember him. We know that if we have a personal relationship with Jesus, the Bible tells us that God remembers our sins no more. They are buried, they are gone, they are forgotten. And so if God doesn't remember those things anymore, then why do we? Now, that's a big question, and we don't have time to answer it completely, but I will tell you this. One of the reasons why we remember the things that we need to forget is because there is an enemy at work in our lives who many times goes out of his way to remind us of those things that we need to forget. And if we're not careful in the Christian life, we can forget who we are in Christ. some of you may know this about me, most of you probably don't, but I love the ocean. I love everything about the ocean. I love the water, what's under the water. I love the waves. I love everything about the ocean. I love being in the ocean. I love being in the waves. And so many of you can relate to this. If you've ever been to the ocean and you walk through the sand and you walk into the water and you walk out just a little ways, maybe you're up to your waist, maybe even your chest, and you're up and you're out there in the waves and you're playing around, you're goofing around, you're having a great time, and you've been out there for a little while, and before you know it, you turn around and you realize that you've been carried hundreds of feet, maybe even hundreds of yards from where you first walked into the ocean. That's how powerful the ocean is, even on a calm day. And the wind and the waves and the currents of the ocean can carry us away from where we first walked in. Well, if I'm not careful in the Christian life, in my daily walk with Christ, if I'm not careful, I can forget who I am. If I'm not careful, I can find myself drifting away from where I first walked in, forgetting the things that I need to remember. And I'll find myself out there somewhere, being swept away, being pulled away by the currents of life. And so this evening, I want to talk to you just about the fact that we need to remember who we are, because it's so easy to be pulled away by the currents of life, forgetting who we are, forgetting our true identity, forgetting who we are in Christ, forgetting the fact that we're loved, forgetting the fact that we're valuable, cared for, and loved. And so this evening, as we get ready to take the Lord's Supper, as we journey back to that upper room, as we journey back through those dusty streets of Jerusalem to that house and up those stairs and into that upper room to that table where we sit down and we listen, we'll hear Jesus tell us to remember him, to remember what he's done for us, to remember who we are in him, and to remember the hope that we have in him for the future. And so as we get ready to take these elements, the bread and the juice, we want to make sure that we're in a right standing with our Heavenly Father. And so a simple question that you can ask is this: God, is my life pleasing to you? Is my life pleasing to you? My thoughts, my words, my action, are those things pleasing to you? And then ask him to reveal those areas in your life that are not pleasing to him. And so as we spend just this next little bit where you begin asking that question and you begin reflecting about your own heart, your own mind, your own life, I'm gonna give you just a couple of moments to do that. And as you do, I'm gonna read three verses out of 1 Corinthians chapter 11 that remind us why we ask ourselves these questions. In verse 27 through 29, it says this: "So then, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sin against the body and blood of the Lord. Let a person examine himself. In this way, let him eat the bread and drink from the cup. For whoever drinks and eats without recognizing the body eats and drinks judgment on himself." And so in this moment, as you have been examining your heart and your life with your Heavenly Father, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna take the bread, again, that represents the body that was broken for you, and the juice that represents the blood that was spilled for you on your behalf. And so let's go ahead and do that right now. I'm gonna read just a couple of more verses and we'll go ahead and take those together right now. The bread first, in 1 Corinthians 11, in verse 23 and 24, it says this: "The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me." As we wrap up our time tonight, as we think about things in our lives sometimes that happen There are things sometimes when life decides to throw us a curveball that happen in our life, and it can seem sometimes that we are sitting in the darkness of that Friday and Saturday of Easter weekend. There are times in our lives where things happen and it feels like the fresh air of hope has been completely sucked right out of the room. And it is so easy in those moments for doubt and fear and uncertainty to creep into our lives. You imagine Mary and the disciples and his followers that Friday and Saturday. Imagine the doubt and the fear and the uncertainty that crept into their lives. And so as we find ourselves here today, walking through and dealing with something we never thought we would have to walk through or deal with, I want to leave you with one thought. One thought, as those fears and those doubts and those uncertainties creep into your life, for all of us in different degrees, but as those things begin to creep into your life, I want to encourage you to do this. I want to encourage you to remember Jesus. I want to encourage you to remember the hope that we have in Him. And in those moments where it feels like all hope is lost, in those moments where it feels like hope is fleeting, in those moments where it feels like for some of you that hope has vanished completely, I want to encourage you in those moments to remember Jesus. And then we can call on the source of all hope. And then finally, to remember that the darkness of Friday and Saturday crumbled under the marvelous light of Sunday. Let's pray together. Father, we just want to thank you for this time that we've been able to have through music and through just setting aside some time to focus on you and to observe the Lord's Supper. And so, Father, I pray that as we have done that, I pray again that it has been a blessing to you. And so, Father, I pray that as we wrap up our time right now, as we pray and we say amen and we go about the rest of our evening and our weekend, Father, I pray that our focus would be on you, as Drew reminded us in that song. Father, help us to turn our eyes upon Jesus, not just when we're struggling, but when things are going well. Father, that our eyes would be fixed on Jesus all the time. And so, Father, we thank you for what only you can do. Father, we need you. God, I pray that you would replace fear and uncertainty and doubt with calmness and confidence and courage. Father, we want to tell you how much we love you. In Jesus' name.